certainly has come a long way from when it started 30 years ago.
It certainly has, Bessie. When it started in 1978, it started as a protest rally with just over 1,000 people here on the infamous Oxford Street.
Well, can you believe it? Tonight there's going to be 10,000 people marching on hundreds of floats. It's set to be the biggest yet. The theme is Brave New World, and I think it's really important to remember why it is we're celebrating.
You're certainly right, Bessie. When they started marching 30 years ago, they marched to say no to discrimination, no to homophobia, and yes, we support our gay child.
I'm here with one of the first people from 78. How does it feel to be here 30 years later?
It's really wonderful. We think about what life was like for us in 1978. A new generation of queer people are coming through. They're much more confident. They've got the benefit of our struggles.
Now, there's a lot of serious stuff, but what about the fun stuff? Are you going to be partying tonight?
I'll be in bed by 10.
Oh, boring. The festival this year was brimming with lots of social and cultural events. One of the biggest being Fair Day, where over 60,000 people came along to enjoy the big picnic in the park. It's well known for a fantastic atmosphere and wonderful entertainment. Now, Drew popped along to find out what people there thought of the theme Brave New World and what it meant to them at Fair Day.
The event has been kicked off by an official tree planting ceremony. The tree stands at the end of the parade route to serve a reminder on why we celebrate Mardi Gras. Yes, for our freedom and our rights, and will represent a brighter future for our community here in Sydney. This year's event has been themed Brave New Worlds. Let's go and find out what Brave New Worlds mean to the community here at Fair Day.
Fellas good for the moolah. Now, this year's event has been themed Brave New World. What does that mean to you?
To me, it means doing all those things that you kind of feel that you shouldn't do or that you haven't been able to do. I guess it means taking risks and enjoying life and starting afresh.
Oh, the world changing and accepting.
Exactly. Any other?
I like that.
You like that
one? Yeah, that's good.
Community within themselves getting together and walking around, and it doesn't matter what you look like.
Exactly.
Don't get any shit.
What's your real hair colour?
My real hair colour? Look at the eyebrows.
Tell us about Fair Day. It certainly brings the whole community together.
Absolutely.
How many boys are actually a part of the Sydney Convicts?
There's around about 60 guys. We've got on a week by week basis.
Celebrating the fact that it's been 30 years that we've been spreading the word and it's a brave new world. I envy the youth of today that don't have to go through what we went through 20, 30 years ago.
So that concludes Fair Day 2008. It certainly does bring the community a lot closer together. I guess Brave New Worlds means many different things to many different people, but certainly brings us closer to equal rights here in Australia. Back to you at the parade.
Well, guys, Brave New Worlds is the theme. Tell me what you think. What does that mean to you?
Oh, our theme is we came, we conquered. For me, it's like equal rights is the important thing here, and there's like a few parades with that as the theme, and like that's awesome.
Yeah. Excellent. So, your thoughts?
Yeah. Exactly. Like we've come a long way, but there's still a long way to go. Like, you know, we still have equal rights, and I guess this year's a year of remembering all these guys at the front here that did it for us 30 years ago, made our lives a hell of a lot easier.
Exactly. Happy 30 years.
I always wanted to make T-shirts that say "gay," like "good day," but "gay," like "you're good, you're gay." Happy Mardi Gras. We're talking about me being in Australia and Australia being in me. So to speak. Oh my God, I think I see Olivia Newton-John.
Well, I am here with that queer eye for a straight guy, Carson himself. How are you?
How am I going? Aren't you going to ask me how I'm going?
Oh, how are you going?
They asked me that once on an airplane, just before I was getting on the plane. They said, how are you going? I'm like, on that airplane, hello.
Tell me about the Australian men. Have you met any that have taken your fancy?
I have. Yes.
Yes.
There's one right over there.
Oh, hello.
Taking my fancy and then some.
What beaches have you been to? Because there are 37 beaches within the vicinity of Sydney.
I've only been to two of them. I've been to Tamarama, because I like saying that.
That's like Glamorama for us.
Yeah, I felt at home. Glamorama. Although it kind of can sometimes sound like Glamour Rimmer, which would be bad.
Well, it depends who you're with.
Yeah, but if you're going to be a rimmer, you might as well be a glamorous one.
Exactly.
And I've been to Bondi, and the Lifesavers gave me one of their budgie smugglers.
That's hot.
It's like a special ceremony, and I got the little hat, which I wasn't too fond of.
Yeah, no.
But the bottoms I like.
I am here on the parade line with our very proud Australian Lifesavers. Let's check them out. We're the generation that's gotta be heard. You're tired of your teachers and your schools are drag. You're not gonna win without your own dad. So come on, let me entertain. Hey, how you doing?
I'm working up a little bit of a sweat.
Oh my God, how much fun are we having down here?
Oh, it's been exhausting, but we're going to do it all night long.
Now, you are an official Lifesaver this evening, aren't you?
We certainly are. We've got around about 120 guys and girls behind us, all gay, lesbian. We've got a few of our straight friends as well joining us.
Now, take us through your outfit. What if it gets cold down there?
Well, we'll have nipples like bullets, so there you are. That's always a hot thing, I think.
It is. Now, you're a gorgeous Lifesaver. The Lifesavers are an important part of our Australian community.
They
now,
certainly
you're
are.
You're actually down at North Bondi, aren't you?
North Bondi, but we've actually got Lifesavers from Bondi, Tamarama, people from the Central Coast, Western Australia, South Australia, Tasmania, and also Northern Territory. Oh, Queensland as well.
Wow, we all like Queensland, Prince Vegas.
We
have a wonderful Mardi Gras.
Thanks.
Sydney certainly knows how to throw an amazing 30th birthday party.
Don't we? I mean, this festival has been running for 3 weeks. It's not just about the parade, you know. There's been over 100 events.
That there have. We've had the Queer Screen Film Festival, the pool party, and Sol y Luna Mardi Gras Harbour Party 2008. I went down with the Hot Dan Slater to check it out. Please don't stop the music. We're down here at Lady Macquarie's chair on Sydney's harbour for one of the world's sexiest parties on the international circuit. Mardi Gras Harbour Party, Sol y Luna. Doing Dan?
Great, Drew. I knew you couldn't miss this party.
I know. What a party and what an amazing view.
It's fantastic.
Now, Dan, this is probably one of the most iconic parties on the Mardi Gras circuit. They brought together legendary promoters, Fuzzy, to help bring this together. Think Park Life, Harbour Life and Field Day.
Yep.
So it's certainly a party that I couldn't miss.
Oh, look, it's got a truly diverse crowd and people fly in from all over the world just to come to this party.
That they do. It certainly does have the world's sexiest people, including you, Mr. Dan.
Oh, thank you. I'm blushing.
Now, Dan, why do you think people come to Sydney for Mardi Gras?
Well, look, who wouldn't want to come? It's got great beaches, great people, and it's too hard to pass up with a view like this.
It's amazing. Should we go and find out why people like Sydney and an Australian summer?
Let's go check it out.
Now tell me, what do you like best about an Australian summer?
Okay, Australian summers bring out the sexy boys, and no one wants to get a farmer's tan, so everyone takes off their singlets as well.
Pretty much a beach boy. I spend most of my summer at the beach.
Which is your favourite beach?
I like to go to Bronte or Tamarama.
The man, the sun, the beach, the water, the beautiful city. Have I mentioned the man?
What's your favourite beach to go to?
Oh,
we like a bit of North Bondi, don't we?
North Bondi and around Tamarama if you want a quiet day.
Exactly. Now, Dan, what else are you up to during Mardi Gras?
Oh, I'm actually putting together the fag tag float. So I've got 45 volunteers marching their way up Oxford Street.
Wow, 45 hot boys. Should we go and take a look at the rehearsal?
Yeah, why not?
Let's take a look.
Oh,
I hope you've had as much fun as I have here at Sol Iluna, the 2008 Harbour Party here on Sydney's foreshore.